In this video, we'll discuss some things to consider when deciding whether or not to pay for an item or service upfront or over time. I mean, we are all faced with this dilemma. Should we make monthly installment payments or one lump sum annual payment? Now, there can be pros and cons to each method, and I would say it's a case-by-case basis because everyone's financial situation is different. But before we get into the video, if you're a returning subscriber, thank you for your continued support. If you're new here, welcome to the family of Joe It Alls. Consider subscribing and turning on the notification bell as I'm posting valuable new content at least twice a week.
The dreaded annual bill. The notification hits your inbox around the same time every year, and it's just like a gut punch.
That comes out of nowhere. I know every time I get my auto, my home, my life insurance bill, I'm like, ugh, it's that time of year again, right? Same feeling when I get a supplemental property tax bill. I'm like, yikes, another large bill that needs to be paid. Now, most of us pay our bills monthly because that corresponds to when we get our paychecks from our job. But insurance companies and certain other service providers sometimes allow you the chance to make a single upfront annual payment, and they may even give you a discount to do so. If you can't afford to pay these in lump sums, then the question becomes whether the discount is big enough to make it worth your while to pay in advance. Now, the most common expenses in which you can often choose between annual or monthly payments are insurance premium. Whether it's your auto or homeowner's insurance, most companies calculate premiums on an annual or semi-annual basis. But to make it easier for their customers, they also let you pay your premiums monthly. Now, some companies structure those monthly payments with an added convenience fee, while others just give you a discount for paying upfront on an annual basis. Now, regardless of the method, guys, the net result is that you'll pay less for an upfront payment than you would if you stretch it out monthly. Now, although paying an expensive bill upfront can seem overwhelming, you may be able to save significant money by paying it all upfront versus installments. Let's say you have an auto insurance premium that came in at $1,000 for the year, but you were given the option of paying $100 each month. Now, the monthly amount does seem more manageable, but you'll end up paying $1,200 over the course of the year rather than $1,000. Now, that additional $200 ends up being an extra $16.60 per month. The additional $200 in savings could potentially be invested or go towards paying down an additional bill or debt you may have. It's not just the insurance industry that has these type of payment arrangements. Expenses like memberships, subscriptions, childcare, and private school tuition often come with the big incentive to pay all at once and get significant savings in return. Again, guys, everyone's situation varies, and you will need to weigh the cost of paying more over the long run versus having the convenience of monthly payments. Now, acknowledging that you can save money by paying a large bill upfront does not exactly mean that you have the cash readily available when the bill's due, especially if the expense exceeds your paycheck. All right, guys, so if you do decide that paying upfront annually is best for you, I would recommend budgeting for that expensive bill. Truth is, guys, tackling an expensive annual bill takes time and commitment. In order to prepare and budget for these type of expenses, you can set up a separate account called a sinking fund. Now, a sinking fund is basically a pool of money that you regularly contribute to so that you can break up a large expense into more manageable chunks. For example, if you had 12 months to save for next year's $1,000 auto insurance premium, saving $84 in your sinking fund each month will get you to that goal. To calculate your sinking fund contributions, take the total and divide it by the number of months you have for making the payment, or the number of weeks if you're adding to the fund weekly. Now, in addition to a monthly or weekly contributions, you can funnel any extra money to your sinking fund to save for additional items later down the road. Now, when it comes to where to stash your savings, put your money where you won't be tempted to spend it, but can easily access the funds when it's time to make your payment. A high yield savings account can be a great option, as you can grow and put your money to work at an online bank while saving. If you have more than one sinking fund, you could choose to open multiple savings accounts or use one account and just keep a record of your contributions and how much you still need to reach each goal. No matter how you go about doing it, the main point is that you're prioritizing savings in your budget so you can tackle that expensive bill upfront and reduce your overall cost. Now, with that being said, Joe It Alls, there may be times where this concept, while very useful, may need some caution. So there are some times in which paying upfront may not be the best. So if you are still paying off debt, paying in full may not be appropriate just yet. Also, if you can only pay the full amount using a credit card that you can't pay in full, this is definitely not appropriate for you, and it doesn't even count as you're not paying in full. Only pay in full if you know for a fact that you're going to be using the product or service. For example, if you never stick to, let's say, an exercise plan, think twice about buying a full year of personal training sessions. Start smaller to establish good habits. If you do not commit to a year of, let's say, that training session or anything else, make sure there's a money-back guarantee or any loophole if your situation changes. So again, Joe-dawgs, it's important to note that this isn't an end-all, be-all solution. You need to pay attention to what you're buying. For example, if you're buying something that offers maybe a large amount of tax deductions or provides a great cash flow, this may be something that makes sense to pay over time. Also, you need to make sure that you can afford to pay upfront. If you don't have the savings to do so safely, then it's probably a better idea to pay over time. However, with good savings habits, you should eventually be able to put yourself into a position where you can pay upfront more often. If you found value in the video, please be sure to hit that like button. It helps me out a ton with the YouTube algorithm. Share this video on all your social media platforms and